As you may read from the title of this video, we are going to practice some Magento 2 development techniques, and we will start building block module for Magento 2. If you are new here, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel. My name is Max Pronko, and let's dive into the module creation. First of all, I'm going to create a new repository, so I will hold all my source code of the extension in a separate repository. This is a good practice when you build some third-party extensions that can be installed for Magento 2 application. So let's go ahead and name this repository Magento 2 block, or Magento 2 block module. This is going to be our name of repository. Description of this repository is going to be block extension for Magento 2. And this is going to be public repository, so you can get back to this repository later if you would like to check out the source code. And we're going to create all this. Yeah, let's go ahead and create add a readme file as well. And our default branch is going to be main. And let's hit create repository. All right, so we have our Magento 2 block module repository created. Let's go ahead and click code and copy a link to our new repository. In the source code, I've already installed Magento 2.4.4. And for this lesson, we're going to use PHP 7.4. I also use, so this is a local installation of Magento 2. I use Mac OS, and I have MariaDB for database, Elasticsearch, PHP Composer first, as far as I remember. Composer, yeah, first edition. And so this is a vanilla Magento without any third-party modules installed. The only thing I did for Magento 2.4.4, I did switch off a module called Magento 2-Factor AUS. It adds additional logic when you try to log in. So we don't need this module, or I don't need it on my local, so I decided to switch it off for improving my developer experience. I'm going to create a new directory under app, and this directory is going to be called code, and inside code directory I will create a directory that is going to be called MageMastery. And inside this directory we can navigate to app code MageMastery and execute git clone command and paste location of our block module. Yeah, the only problem I forgot to name correctly a directory, so let me redo it again and call a directory where we are going to clone our repository block. All right, so we have MageMastery block and readme file. And this is our first step. Let me go ahead. And make a change so I can see that my workflow works correctly. So let me navigate to block directory. And let me add a file, git status readme.md, that is correct. And let's execute git commit minus m and message updated readme. Git push origin main. Yeah, so this flow works for me. And the next step would be to create two required files. The first one is registration.php, and we are going to add it into a repository And for this file, I'm going to search any existing file. Let me open a vendor directory. Magento. Any of the files, for example, this one, and paste it. So what it's going to do for me, it's going to register a new module called MageMasteryBlock. And the second file I have to create inside the etc directory of a block directory. And this file is going to be called module.xml. I will add this file into the repository as well. And so this file is going to contain a name of our module. And let's go ahead and enable our module by running bin magento module enable and name of a module MageMasteryBlock. So it was successfully enabled. The second command we have to run is bin magento setup upgrade, so it will register our module in the system. Of course, there is nothing to be executed or nothing will change for the system except the fact that this is a registered Magento 2 module, and in order to have some functionality, block functionality, we have to add some logic. And we are going to do this just in a second. So for the first step for our block module, I'm going to add a file called db-schema.xml. This file is going to be used to add, as it's called, db-schema. And for db-schema, I'm going to go to existing module, Magento module called module CMS. And from the CMS module, I will use the content of this file, DB schema, and customize for our needs. As part of this DB schema, what we're going to create is a database table called MageMasteryBlock, and we're going to create post. And this table is basically similar to CMS page table. However, we're going to change something or adjust our table schema in order to match our requirements. So let's go ahead and update comment MageMasteryBlock post table. And let's go one by one. So instead of page ID that is auto increment, we are going to have post ID. And we can rename a comment for this one. We're going to have title, page layout. We will get rid of this field. Method keywords description, identifier. We don't need identifier as of now. Content heading. I think we don't need it, but we can revisit our decision at a later stage. Creation time, update time, is active. Let's remove is active. Sort order. We don't really need a sort order. Layout update, custom theme, custom root template. No, and these two layout columns as well. As well as this custom theme from and to, as we're not going to add such logic for now. Our primary key is a constraint and is going to be a post ID. Also, we don't have identifier, so let's get rid of this identifier. And index, we might need to keep title, meta keywords, description, and content, full text. We can get rid of this one. Probably let's get rid of it so we will not overcomplicate our table. And this is a table that we are going to use for a post entity. So first step in our block creation is to create a database table called MageMastery block post, and this table is going to contain all our posts of this module. So in order to execute this query and execute a dbschema.xml file and create a table, we have to run command setup upgrade. However, I'm also going to run an argument try run equals one. So while it's running, the idea behind try run equals one is to, instead of executing this table creation query, we are going to see all changes that are going to be just before it's going to be executed. We're going to see it in a log file, so we can ensure that SQL that is generated based on this file is correctly generated and all our fields are correct. This is a very handy tool that allows us to better understand what we wrote in this XML file. And in order to find this file, we have to go to var log directory, and dryrun installation.log file is created. And as we can see, we have MageMastery blog post table with post ID, title, keywords, description, content, creation time, update time, meta title, and yeah, looks like everything is correct. Page meta title, let's update, it's going to be post creation time, post modification time, post meta title, and yeah, this comments as well. We can rerun this command again to see that our query has been successfully changed, and just before we will execute, we will see that everything is fine. All right, let's refresh our log. And as we can see, we have all changes applied, and it's safe to assume that we will successfully create a new table. And let's run Bin Magenta setup upgrade one more time, however, without dry run equals one argument. So this will execute a query and will create a table in a database. Let's go ahead and check that we've successfully created a table. Via terminal, let's go to a database, and in order to check database name, you can check under app.etc.env.php file, and if you will scroll down db connection default db name, you will find the name of a database. Let's copy this name and use it in our connection. So let's find out if we've created a table, MageMastery blog post. And as we can see, we have our table created with a post ID, title, meta keyword, description, content, creation, update time, meta title, and primary key is post ID. And let's go ahead and push our changes, git status, git add, git commit, added post table, git push origin main and refresh our repository. Alright, so this is a first step in our block module creation. In the next video we are going to create additional files, PHP files, that will help us to query our database table.